Now, the son and namesake of late dictator Ferdinand Marcos, still the most preferred presidential candidate in Pulse Asia's final pre-election survey. Bongbong Marcos retained his 56% preference rating. Still at second place, Vice President Lenny Robredo with a 23% score, a 1 percentage point drop from her figures in March. Senator Manny Pacquiao now at third place, overtaking Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, who fell to the fourth spot. Senator Ping Lacson rounded out the top five. As for the vice presidential race, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte is still the front runner, with 55% of respondents supporting her. Senate President Vicente Soto III is a distant second with 18%. The survey was conducted from April 16 to 21. The Philippine poll body assures the public their investigation into the scrapped presidential and vice presidential town hall debates will not affect the preparations for the May 9 elections. Commissioner George Garcia gave that assurance after his fellow commissioner, Ray Bulay, recommended the temporary relief of James Jimenez and Francis Arabe, both directors of the COMELEC's Education and Information Department, following the debate fiasco. Garcia says COMELEC Chairman Sideman Pangarungan and the en banc have yet to act on Bulay's recommendations.
Until today, we'd like to clarify that Director James Jimenez remains to be our official spokesperson, mm-hmm. and he remains to be the Director of Education Information Department, and Director Arabe remains to be likewise the Deputy Director of said department. That we cannot rock the boat at this time. At this point, we have to prepare for the election.
The COMELEC town hall debates, which were originally scheduled last weekend, were canceled due to financial issues with the COMELEC's third-party contractor, Impact Hub. This prompted the poll body to conduct panel interviews with the presidential and vice presidential bets instead. But most of the leading candidates declined to participate, mainly due to scheduling conflicts amid the last stretch of the campaign period.
Even if only one candidate will agree and to proceed with a panel interview, we will proceed. It is our commitment, likewise, to the Filipino people. They have to know their candidates. 1 hour is 1 hour, and therefore, that is enough for them to at least maybe change their minds or at least to strengthen or cement their choice already. And at the same time, to even perhaps look into these candidates who may not be high in surveys, but just the same, they're offering themselves to the people. Mm. Perhaps we can likewise listen to them and listen to what they want for the country.
Catch the COMELEC's panel interviews on May 3 to 6 via the online platforms of ABS News, ANC, and ABS-CBN Teleradio. The COMELEC also guarantees there will no longer be any hours-long glitches in the upcoming elections. Commissioner George Garcia explains the 7-hour glitch during the 2019 midterm elections was caused by a bottleneck in incoming data from several precincts. But he insists their servers have already been upgraded.
We upgraded the system at the same time. Okay. From this server, the transparency server in UST, meron po kaming nilagay na isang equipment na kung saan by bulk yung pagbagsak ngayon sa mga media server, yung sa laptop po ng mga media natin. Before po kasi kahit sa manggaling na presinto, try to imagine you have 106,000 precincts nationwide. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. So kung 106,000, noon po 80,000 ngayon, 106,000. And then po papasok lahat doon sa transparency server. Tapos ibabato sa mga media server in yung raw data, yeah. that would be problematic. This time, it will be by bulk.